I mean, it's actually looking like a solid unit in there now. Everything's pristine and clean. We're just gonna do a final wipe down with some microfiber cloths. But yeah, like, it is looking like a genuine collectible. Good old classic car. Still original, except for that bloody radio. Do you ever just get sick of the stuff that you have laying around and you can't sort of find a spot for it, and you just shuffle it and tidy it and move it and it's still there but it just looks neater? That's one of the things that needs to be shuffled around right now, I tell you. Whether the car's going to auction or it's going to be sold just privately through classified ads, I've got to present it, right? So that's been the whole process of the car. Inside's pretty much done. I've got a few little bits and pieces to do. I bought this car, believe it or not, it's already 6 months since I've purchased the car. It's been a long, long process. And I'm not sure of the history regarding the paint care done prior to that. It has, according to the previous owner, the guy in between here, I've actually owned it longer than him almost, believe it or not. It did have a respray at some point. I was unable to get the details on that, but it's not original paint. So I've got a bit of an issue with that. I don't know if it's a one-stage or a two-stage paint. Two-stage has got a clear coat on it. I think it has. We'll find that out when we're detailing it. One-stage paint is the old-fashioned paint, and when you polish it, you end up with the color all over your rag. I hope we don't have that. The car itself is in need of some skincare, basically. The paint, if you listen, I'll bring the camera over. Now, it's got dust on it, of course. Right, and you can see the dust on the roof. It says not good, but if I just, you can just... Okay. It's rough and it's porous, so we need to attend to that firstly with clay bar. So clay bar is just a way of exfoliating the skin, so to speak, and peeling back the junk that's been resting and sort of living on the skin of the car, the paint. We're going to do a snow foam wash first. That'll be a foam and rinse, and then re-foam and wash with the foam. And then we will move on to clay barring, and then after that we're going to start on the actual paint correction or detailing. We're going to do a cut and then a polish. I'm not sure if it needs much of a cut. This will unveil itself as we clean it. So let's have a look at what we're going to be using today in order to attack this. We've got our snow foam. We're going to put that on first, rinse it down a couple of times, and then we're going to wash the car. I'll talk about the correct way to wash. Clay bar here we're going to use. This has been, it's nothing wrong with it, but it's just because it's been so hot here in Brisbane, it's actually gone all soft and melted. But we'll be using that. And then we're going to use my trusty old, very cheap dual action polisher. Still going after many years of hard service. We've got a variety of cutting compounds here. This is the one I will prefer to use, would prefer to use. They're getting a little bit old now. So we've got a cutting compound, and then we start polishing. We've got, wrong way around here, 2,500 grit, I guess you'd call it. And then we've got our 4,000, so that moves it up towards a glassy finish. We've got our cutting pads and then our polishing pads, Brasso for all the chrome, and then at the end we may do a candy wax. I did that on the Corolla, if anyone was watching that and saw it. If not, go and check that out. I put a link up in the corner here. That really popped after doing the exact same process. Paint was a lot newer, obviously. Through all of this, I've got a number of really nice microfiber towels, so we'll be using those to wipe down in between our sessions of cutting and polishing. Years ago, we used to all use chamois, those like leather bits of skin. They were all dry and brittle, and then you'd wet them and they'd get all nice and soft and you could dry your paint. They're sort of old school now. I use a microfiber towel. It's a high GSM, I think 1200 GSM, whatever that means, but it's very absorbent. The idea is to actually have a bit of moisture in this. So you hydrate it and then you wipe down the sections of the car to dry it. So that's really important. The idea is to eliminate installing dust back on the car, or micro dust particles, as you're washing, because that's what creates our swirl marks and our very fine scratches. So we want to try and eliminate that. There's going to be a lot on there. I want everything off the car to a degree so that I can access it, like the badge here, see? I can get under that and clean it. The indicators were off, the lenses, but I don't want to wet it too much and get the connections too wet, so I've put them on temporarily. I will take them off to detail around them. Headlights have already been done, so it doesn't matter if they get wet. You can see I polished those up a while back. That was in our Christmas video, I think. So yeah, how do we go about washing it? Let's have a look. We're going to use what's called the two bucket method. It's actually the three bucket method. The third bucket is usually for your wheels. And when you're washing your car, you'd start off with the dirtiest part, the wheels, and use a separate bucket for that. We've already done the wheels. We've painted them and cleaned them up. So that's not an issue today. So we're running with a two bucket method. One is a wash bucket. So the suds will go into this one, wash mitt in there, and we'll have a rinse bucket. In the bucket, we have grit guards. So this just is where you can dip in and all the gunk falls through the grit guard into the bottom, so we're not picking that up and washing it again on the skin or the paint. Nice microfiber wash mitt. Got plenty of those, so that's handy. As I said, we've got our high microfiber GSM, whatever you want to call it, microfiber towel. We've got two versions of that. This one's a bit lighter. I've sort of mixed between the two of them when I'm doing it. I'm no expert at this, but and it's been done 1,000 times online or on YouTube. This is just me explaining how I'm going to do it today. We also have a grit guard in the rinse bucket. So we'll use the wash bucket, wash, and then we rinse in this bucket. So the contaminants, the majority of them go into there. And again, the grit guard stops us from hitting the bottom and picking up that gunk. So that's that. Now, how do we go about washing it? There is a little way or a little pattern to do it, so let's have a look. A lot of what I've learned and done, I learned through a guy called Larry at M-O-N-Y-C. Bloody good YouTuber, a fantastic channel, and I learned a lot over the years, and it's helped me do a lot of my cars, and they always come up pristine, beautiful. How to steam clean, leather, interior cleans, and of course the exterior, which is really important. So, from his descriptions and from what I've done and what I've seen other people do, your car sort of grades from not too dirty down to bloody dirty at the bottom. So we're going to work from the top down. We're going to do it in segments. Basically, from the center at the roof, out to the boot and the bonnet, down through the glass. So that's our cleanest area. We're going to do that first. Then we'll do a rinse, okay, in the rinse bucket. The next phase will be basically the sides of the car with the windows on the sides. We'll work from the window line down to about halfway where this sort of door protector is on the car. Both sides, so work my way around it. Probably leave the back boot area, like the back taillight area, and the front till we get to the lower section. So again, after that we're going to rinse. Then we're suds up again and we're going to wash the bottom part of the car. This is probably where it's going to be the grubbiest. I'm going to snow foam it, let it agitate. So the foam's concept of the foam is to agitate the dust particles and pull them into the foam, and then we rinse that off. Wash it down using that method and rinse that off and then dry it. This is our foaming lance. The snow foam goes into this. I think it's like 100 mils to the bottle here. If you don't have a pressure washer, there is a different version. I do not have that. But there is a tap version that can connect straight to your standard hose fitting. I've got the old Karcher here. Simply disconnect this portion like that. And then we connect this on, and away we go. You will see that. So I'm going to mix up some of this. I'm going to get the water on and blah blah blah, yada yada yada. Giving it a complete cover with the snow foam, 5 or 6 minutes, letting it sit, don't let it dry, and then we'll rinse it off and then we'll give it a hand job. Behold the holy grail. I just have to take it off, it's full of leaves. So I don't want stuff constantly coming out, so put that aside and we'll clean that later. Yeah, so even though it seemed clean, every time I ran the water blaster over that louver, leaves just kept blowing out everywhere. That was a problem. Needed to remove it, and I literally blew away years and years and years of built up leaves. Then you can see I moved on to the drying phase immediately after that, using both versions of those good quality drying towels. Car's washed, looks damn sight better. It's not bad, but it still feels rather gritty. You can hear that. It's not nice and smooth. So this is where we're gonna get in with the clay bar first. I don't know if you can see the corner here, and you can see, right, there it is, there you go. So you see all of that little fine scratching and swirling? Little focus, there we go. That's pretty much car wide. So now we're gonna clay bar. Back in the Corolla video, we worked with this stuff, clay bar. This is new, it's just melted. Oh, geez. Very hard to get out of here. Struth. Usually it's a square or rectangular shaped bar like this. Usually about a third of a bar when it comes to the car. The idea is to make this into like a, basically like a patty, a beef patty. Flatten it out. Now it will get dirty, I'll show you that, but and as it gets dirty, all you do is rotate it and roll it and knead it into a new shape. So we've got our patty cake. We're gonna take some suds, like this. There's my lubricant. Let me just put it on, press it, and just start backwards and forwards, like this. Try to always use sideways motions, no circular motions. So we can go this way for the corners, and then like this. More lubricant, and straight away that feels nice and glassy, what we want. So I will continue to do this over the whole car.
Clay barring is so satisfying. Just remember, you do need lubricant in order to move the bar nicely and to not damage the paint surface. Water is fine, you can use just plain water, soapy water, and you do not have to use the lubricant they sell at the auto shops.
1000% better. I know there's a bit of water on there, but seriously, I love clay bar. It is an amazing product. So we'll dry that again. And we'll start cutting it slightly. I'm only going to do one light cut, I think. I'm not going to go stupid with it. We'll see how the paint responds, whether I'm lifting too much off or any colour comes out. And then we'll do maybe one pad, I call it one pad cut, one pad polish. Anyway, moving on.
I did use the microfiber towels to dry again, but I'm using the compressor here just to get the last remaining dribbles of water out of those little nooks and crannies so that it doesn't run into my cutting compound.
I've got some nice microfiber cloths cleaned. I'm not going to go too crazy on these detailed areas, maybe just the main flat panels. I'm not going to go over this. That's just going to make a mess. Normally you'd be very careful on your edges so you don't burn them out. But this is a softish pad, and I'm not putting much weight here. I'm not going over those edges too much, so it should not be a problem.
Place four spots of compound on your pad, and then just sort of dab that around evenly on the surface you wish to work on. Not too big an area.
Spread it around, do a patch at a time. Now turn it up. I'm not going to go full speed, I'll go about 3/4.
Work backwards and forwards in lines or rows, overlapping about half a pat, 50% at each pass, and probably go a little slower than I'm doing here, and alternate between left to right and forward and back on the surface you're working on. Wipe it down and inspect the results.
Immediately, starting, I can see some scratches here. So it is a two-stage paint, so that's a nice coat of clear on there. That looks better, but now it's brought up some minor imperfections there. So we'll hit that again. Enough for me.
Satisfied with the results, I continue to move my way around the car, just cutting back into a point where I could remove pretty much all the swirls and fine marks. I wasn't too worried about the really heavy stuff. On the rear of the car, I decided to go around the tail lights and the number plate. Had to do that all by hand.
All right, we are one stage down. We could cut it a lot more, but I mean, it's actually in very good condition. Some deeper scratches in there that, you know, I could work longer and longer to get out, but I'm not Larry from Ammo, so I'm Adam from Brisbane, and I'm just going to make it as sharp as I can in the shortest space of time. Change to a polishing pad. I'm going to use the Super Finish High Gloss polish. Just do a once over with it, wipe it down, and then I'm going to use the spray wax today. It's a lot quicker. I want to get this thing back on with wheels and everything by, did you see that? By tonight or tomorrow. So, let's get on with this.
Smoke. Yeah, I forgot to record the polishing segment, so we don't have any footage of that, but it is just what I was doing with the cutting compound and cutting pad, just that the polishing pad is a lot softer and we have a very fine compound to help glass up the paint. Then I whacked on some of that spray-on wax and she looked a treat.
We're gonna call it quits for today. Took, what is the time? 4:30, and I started on this at about 10 today. This is a good 6 hours of elbow grease. It looks good. I mean, look at the reflections now. Oops. So I've decided to just get everything on now so that we can get the car running. I'm going to get a roadworthy and registered in the next day or two. And we'll get a reflection there. I was going to do the bumpers as well today, but it's 4:30. It's Sunday. I've done nothing but this and editing and other things, so I need to clean up. Clean up and we'll get back to this. Yeah, maybe tomorrow or the next day. Oh no! Stupid shit. I gotta kill myself.